Hey guys, welcome back again to our channel and Captain Basu channel. I recommend it to everybody to watch this video until end. We will make it separately in three parts, and Captain Basu will explain everything to our viewers. And then my recommended, second recommended, subscribe Captain Basu channel. I will leave everything down in the description. Today, our topic is very important. Please focus with this topic, how to create a passive plan, and Captain Basu will give us good intro about.
Hi, Hamad. Very nice to see you after quite some time.
Yes.
We are meeting after a long time this time. So, as you said, I want to cover the passage plan in three sections, and all three are very important. At the end of this session, I'm expecting the people who, the viewers who would watch, would have a very clear idea on how to make the passage plan, what are the requirements, and what questions you can expect during an inspection, or how to basically make it to remain compliant so that you are ready for any inspection also, and you are safe on board. You know, you make a good passage plan.
Yeah.
So first part of this series, I want to give a very broad overview how you will, what are the things you should remember, what are the things you should consider, why you are making the passage plan, and just a broad idea. And second part, I want to address some of the questions which your viewers had given me, the questions which you had sent
yes.
me. I think there were about 10 questions which the viewers had asked, and we will address those questions one by one. That is the second part. The third part is most important. The third part, we will actually take a look actually at a passage plan, and I'm going to show you exactly how from when you go from one point to another point, one port to another port, how, which are the different areas and what are the things you should mark on the ECDIS, what are the things you should take care and how you should mark them. Okay.
Okay.
So let's start with the first part. Let me share. I hope you can see this. Yeah.
Yeah. Passage plan. Okay. Let's do it.
All right. So you don't have to worry about too much about the technical words. You know, you have to understand what we are trying to do here. So when we are planning a passage, it's just like you are traveling to some new place. Let's say you live in Alexandria and you
yes.
want to go to Sharm el Sheikh. Okay?
Okay.
You've never been to Sharm el Sheikh. Okay.
Yeah.
So what is the first thing that you do? What is the first thing? The first thing, you collect information. Okay. You collect information about Sharm el Sheikh. Which are the areas I will go? How will I go there? How to, you know, that first part always is you are looking through Google and YouTube, trying to find out more and more about that place, and also more and more information on how to go there, because you have to go.
Yes.
So the first part we call, that is the first step to any passage plan.
Mm-hmm.
It is called appraisal. Appraisal means only collect the information about that place and how to go to that area. Let's say you are going from Singapore to Japan, or Singapore to Tokyo, let's say. Okay?
Okay.
So you have to know everything about this passage. I will get into the details later on, but this step is called appraisal.
Appraisal.
So
yeah.
This is called appraisal. The second part, now you have the information. Now you have to start planning. So when you have all the information with you, you plot the courses, you find out, you draw the chart, you know, on the ECDIS, you plot the courses, and that step is called planning.
Mm-hmm.
The next two steps, coming back to the same example, let's say you are going from Alexandria to Sharm el Sheikh. Okay?
Okay.
And you already have information. And now you have also planned your passage. Okay, I will take this bus, or I will take this train to that place. And you have all the information to go. Now, appraisal is done. planning is done. The third and the fourth step is very important. And third and fourth step almost goes together. Third step is execution. Final step is monitoring.
Yes.
I'm sorry, the monitoring came first, but actually yeah, no execution problem. And monitoring.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So execution and monitoring is basically you have started the voyage. Now you have to make sure that you're following the passage, which you have planned. You have planned the passage in the planning stage, but now execution means to execute, to do something.
Yeah.
To carry out your passage. That is execution. And M is monitoring. Monitoring is you are checking every step that you are following the correct route or not. You have to sometimes change your route. You have to correct your route sometimes because of weather. You cannot exactly follow the same route. Sometimes there is too much traffic, so you need to deviate. Sometimes you cannot stay exactly on the planned
yes.
track because of a lot of reasons. Uh-huh. So that is the monitoring part of it. These are the four steps of passage planning. If you understand these steps one by one individually, you will be an expert. So let's start with the appraisal. In the appraisal stage, what you are going to do is that you are going to gather all the information from everywhere before you start going to the exits or before you start plotting the position, plotting the courses or anything. You have to start the appraisal stage. So you have to make sure that all your ENCs are up to date. Now, someone asked me last in one of the questions, someone asked me that how to make sure that your ENCs are up to date.
Yes.
Every EGDIS has a different procedure. I cannot tell you what is the procedure on your vessel, but every week you are getting updates for the ENCs. And it is your job, if you are the second officer or you're the navigating officer, it is your job to understand and make sure that your EGDIS is up to date. And when you update the EGDIS for that week, you have a screen. Now, every EGDIS, the procedure may be different, but you always have a screen where you will see that this EGDIS is updated to such and such notice, such and such week. Let's say, as an example, week number 18 is going on now, let's say.
Mm-hmm.
And you are receiving the updates every Saturday for the next week.
Yes.
So Saturday, you will receive the update. You will put the update on the EGDIS. And when the EGDIS is up to date, you will see on the EGDIS that this EGDIS has been updated to so and so week. Now, does it mean all the charts everywhere in the world is updated in the EGDIS? No. Only the charts which you have purchased. You have on the EGDIS. You have to install your charts. You don't. You have to buy the license for those charts. So if I'm going from Singapore to Japan, and I may not need the charts for America, so I will not buy charts for America. I will only buy charts for my area, the area where I am going, or the area where I am normally traveling. For those charts, for those ENCs, when you put the updates, all the ENCs get updated automatically. You normally don't have to do anything else. Of course, you have to think of temporary corrections and preliminary corrections. For the EGDIS, there is a service called AIO, Admiralty Information Overlay.
Yes.
If you activate that service, then together with the EGDIS corrections, your temporary and preliminary corrections will also get updated.
Mm-hmm.
I hope everyone understands what is temporary and preliminary corrections. If something is not a permanent correction on the chart, let's say jetty is being constructed, yes. It is not finished, that will come as a preliminary correction.
Yes.
Later on, it will change to permanent correction.
Mm-hmm.
No, first it will come as preliminary, then it will change to a permanent correction. Sometimes a temporary correction can be a boy has been moved from this position to that position, but it is temporary. It is not permanent. So that may come as a temporary correction. Later on, it will change wherever the new position is, that will become permanent correction. So all these also back in the days, you know, if you think 10 years back, we had to, in the paper charts, we had to correct them one by one with the pencil for the temporary corrections and preliminary corrections. We had to find out. Now it is very easy. Now it is, you simply activate the AIO service. So all your ENCs get updated. But it is very important, whether you are a third officer or a second officer, any navigating officer must understand how you are correcting it and how you can check that it is corrected or not. You understand?
Yes.
Let's say you take over a watch from the second officer. You must also make sure that the chart that you are following is updated or not. Mm-hmm. So you have to check how to check on your EGDIS, which you have on board. So next time when you join the ship, you go and you check how you can verify what is the last weekly correction applied. And it must be the latest week. Okay.
Okay.
So you also have to, when you're collecting the information during the appraisal stage, you also have to consider what are the company instructions regarding the voyage. For example, your company needs minimum so much UKC for Singapore Strait, or your company has told you a certain guideline which you have to know before you start the voyage.
This is navigation manual, right?
Yes, navigation manual, correct. Then you get the weather information. So sometimes you have these companies like, you know, which give you the weather information, like SPOS, or there are other weather, Admiralty Weather Routing, and many other companies which are giving you weather information. Then you have the Admiralty Digital Publications, ADPs, and the ENPs, Electronic Navigation Publications.
Yes.
These are the publications like list of lights and list of radio signals. These
this is very important.
Very important. And very also important. You have to go through these publications to check what is the requirement for that particular port or for that particular passage. For example, when you are going, same example from Singapore to Japan, when you are coming out of Singapore, you have to do the reportings, the VHF reportings for Singapore. As you come out, then you have, as you go up, you have to enter JASREP areas where you have to do the Japanese reportings. And these reporting requirements keep changing, you know. So in the appraisal phase, remember, you're just collecting the information and you're reading, and you're studying all the information to understand what is required. You have not started planning yet. You're just collecting the information.
Yes.
Also, you have to understand security requirements. If you're going into a dangerous area, like, let's say, West Coast of Africa or Gulf of Aden, these areas, before planning the passage, you must understand what are the security requirements. What are the areas you will start planning? Then, based on that, you have to mark your passages and you have to put marks where you will start the security.
Yeah, high risk area, something like that.
High risk areas, voluntary reporting areas,
yes,
all these kind of things. Now,
and I think also remember the agent sometimes they send some information.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. Very good. Now, these are the points which you must remember, that when you go to a port, all the information may not be available, with the publication. Some of the information the agent will tell you. So sometimes I'll give you an example. There is a berth in Singapore, which is a new berth.
Mm-hmm.
And if you go on a VLCC, if you go on a big ship, you will find that the area around the berth, the depth in that area is very shallow. You cannot go. If you see the depths in that area, you cannot, pass over those areas.
Yes.
So you have to ask for additional information if the company is insisting you to go there. You have to make sure you are not unsafe at any point. Remember, the safety of the ship is your responsibility. You are working on behalf of the master, and it's the master's responsibility, but
very important,
you must also make sure. Very important.
Because the people, they think captain can do everything. Should I told them, the second officer also have, our navigator also have more responsibility about passage plan.
Correct. So as a second officer, as a navigating officer, it is definitely your responsibility to make sure that you are not doing anything unsafe, not going anywhere unsafe. So the next step comes is the planning stage. So you plot the courses, take the printouts, you plot the courses based on the information which you have collected. We already discussed the information. You take printouts of the tidal information, you put the no-go areas on the passage. We will go into details of this in the third part of the series. Now is the first part. In the third part, I will show you the exact plottings and the exact details. You have to mark abort points. You have to have contingency plans. What are abort points? Abort points basically is a point from where you have, if you go beyond that point, you have to continue the passage. You cannot turn back from there. So before that point, you have to test everything. Everything is in order or not. Every equipment is working. Your engines are tested. Your steering is tested. Everything is okay. Then only you go ahead. For example, if you are coming to Singapore, the entrance of the Singapore Channel is a point, is an abort point. Because after that, it will be very difficult for you. If something happens, you cannot turn back. So before that, you have to make sure everything is... This abort point has to be marked on the passage plan.
Like very important. Take notes.
Correct. Contingency plans. If something goes wrong, if during your passage, there is an engine failure or something goes wrong, there should be contingency anchorages or safe berths, which you have identified. Even when you fly an airplane, the airlines also finds these contingency airports. If in the middle of the flight, there is some problem, they can land in another airport instead of going to the destination. Same thing for us. We should identify those areas where we can go and anchor. And remember, every ship will be different. If you're on a small ship, your anchorage area will be different.
Mm-hmm.
If you're on a big ship, anchorage area will be different.
Yes.
If you are loaded, your anchorage area will change. If your contingency anchorage will change. Ballast, it is different. So you have to think of that particular passage and you have to plan the passage. This is the planning stage.
This is called a contingency plan for the people to understand. This is other thing about contingency chart because some people, they are mixed.
Correct. Correct. Contingency chart or contingency plan for the, don't confuse it with the fire or other kind of contingency plans. You know, we are talking about contingency plans in passage plans.
In passage plan, that's right.
Execution. Now you have already plotted and planned the voyage. Now you have started the voyage. And when you depart the port, you are set. You have set the speed as per the requirements of the charterers. It can be for one voyage, it can be 12 knots. Another voyage, it can be 14 knots. Depends on the voyage requirements. Also, you have to think of the safe speed for the voyage, which is the safe speed for passing different areas. And make sure you're executing the plan properly and you're making sure that at every stage you're safe. So that is the execution. That is the job which you do every day when you go on watch, when you write your logbook, when you check your courses, when you monitor the passage.
Not only one officer, right? Yeah.
This is for all officers. This is for all officers. And this also applies to the ratings or the cadets who are part of the watch.
Uh-huh.
Anyone who is part of the watch, they are responsible for the monitor, for the execution. Yeah. And the monitoring also. So monitoring means you're plotting the position, you're doing parallel indexing. Basically, you're trying to make sure that the vessel is on the right track. And you're also adjusting your speeds, you're adjusting your destination ETAs so that your ship is always on the right track. So that, for example, if you are going to cross Singapore Strait on a VLCC, you will have to think of the tidal window at which time you have to pass. So you have to adjust your speed to reach at that time. If you reach too early, you may go aground or you may not comply with the Singapore regulations. If you go too late, once again, you will not comply. So you have to adjust your speeds. That is all under monitoring. And you are filling your logbooks, you're setting the speeds, adjusting the speeds. Basically, every day on the passage, you are doing execution and monitoring of the passage. So whenever you are on watch, you are executing the passage and you're also monitoring it.
Okay.
And many companies have this format where once you finish a particular leg of the voyage, you have to sign that, okay, this leg is finished. Yes. That means this leg has been monitored properly and that is the record of that. So I will finish today. This is the end of the first part. But before that, I just want to remind everyone that understanding these things is one thing, but the documentation is also very, very important. You have to understand today, there is a big importance on documentation. So you can know everything, but you also have to make sure that the documentation is in order depending on your company requirements. Every company has a different set of requirements. So if you read your navigation manual, it will tell you what are the requirements to make your passage plan. So you have to, usually there is a passage plan form and you have to fill up that form. And then you have to take the additional printouts, like I said, title information, weather information, all these you have to attach with the form. Depends on the extent of the passage plan or from which place to which place you're going. But you have to make sure all the documentation is in order. And one final thing is that the passage plan must always be from berth to berth. This is something that we have always heard, and this is very, I think everyone knows it, but I must also say it again, that if you have a, don't think that you are only supposed to make the passage plan up to the point of pilot boarding, you know, so even after the pilot boards, you are still responsible for the voyage. Pilot is on the bridge, yes. But you are still responsible for the voyage. When I say you, I mean the captain and the team, which is which includes you. So that is why your passage should start from the berth at which you are starting, or anchorage, if you are starting from anchorage, and go up to the next berth. So remember, and also another thing is any changes. If you have any changes in the passage plan, it must be recorded officially. Don't think it is just a small change or don't worry. No, tomorrow, if you, let's say you had planned that a passage will go up to the berth, but before arriving on at the berth, the terminal tells you that you have to go to the anchorage. You have to stay at anchorage for 2 days and then you will go to the berth. You have to make this official. You have to make a document for this that, okay, new passage plan from anchorage to berth. And the documentation, I'm telling you again and again, it is very, 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 very important. So before I quit, I just want to remind everyone of the what Hamad also said, that I mean, this series which we are doing, we can continue that. And I'd like to address the questions which you guys have. And for that, I would definitely encourage everyone to, you know, subscribe to my channel. And it's the company, it's called Guide to Inspections. Guide to Inspections by Captain D. If you search that, or if you just search Guide to Inspections, it will come up. We will share some very valuable information, which I believe will be helpful to many, many seafarers. And we can always address the questions which you have directly, you know, on that channel.
Yes.
So that's what, yeah. Thank you, Ahmad.
Thank you, Captain. And for today, we will finish already about the first part. Please follow us until we finish passage plan with Captain Basu. Of course, he's doing very good presentation today, really. Thank you. And then we will finish until here and waiting us until we next part for passage plan. Goodbye.